Thank you so much. Thank you for not only for the great presentation and facilitation, but also for keeping time. Please give it up to Andrew.
For the first time, I had three chances. I got it right.
All right. Whew, how did you find that? More information? Do you need to get more speakers, or you had enough? I see in the chat box we had very interesting conversations there. Maybe let's get to see if we still have our guest online. Give us some thumbs up there, sharps, some loves. I see guests are still there. Thank you so much for staying with us. We highly appreciate it that you took some time from a busy schedule to be with us throughout the session. And someone that needs no introduction, Ronette, is here to give a closing remark. After Ronette, we'll come back to say goodbye to everyone. Otherwise, keep locked on. Ronette, the stage is yours.
Thank you. Thank you. I would say good afternoon here on our third day. Feels like it. It's our second day. Yesterday, I promised you 2 days filled with very interesting research delivered by experts from academia, government, and the private sector. And I think we have delivered that. I think we've given you that. We've given you a focus on employment analysis, trying to understand some of these very difficult, what was the question in the environment, the wicked problems that we are dealing with. And I really feel we've had to deal with some of the wicked problems here. We first had Michael Sachs from the Public Economic Policy Team at WITS, and he contextualized some of the issues and present his latest published data that he's pulled together on the policies and how the policies and the available budget are mutually exclusive. And in fact, he showed us how spending growth has fallen to historic lows. And we understand about the jaws of the hippo, that was like a big discussion point in the public finance family a while ago, but he was demonstrating how that is now closing, and not to the, you know, to the detriment is his argument. We had Professor Stephen Friedman, who asked us to refrain from making it all about cost and prices, and to rather point the fingers towards the institutions, or politics, as he's saying today, and institutions, he pointed us to the issues of behaviors, values, and relationships. And I thought that was quite an important input into our thinking, into how we structure what we're going to try and do after a conference like that. The frame that was useful and understanding for us, the very insightful session on the integrating of renewables into our energy system and how we can use blended finance instruments, managing the employment and the social impacts of the energy transition. We're going to come back to that. It will be a session that you will pick up on the GTAC webinar series on a Friday afternoon. So look out for more discussions around that theme as well. We ended yesterday with a wonderful session, sort of eloquently facilitated by the SARS team, by Mamiki Lehole from SARS. And we looked at the interconnection between the income tax, employment, and social security. Andrew here showed us how our personal tax base is declining, and we looked at Vimal Ranchot's presentation on the employment tax initiative. And I heard a lot of questions and comments around that. And we are at the point now where Andrew made a suggestion, made a recommendation here that we consider a system where everybody who now earns below a certain income, a certain threshold, qualify for a tax credit. And in this way, we can target the working poor, the 3 to 5 million working poor that we have in South Africa. So that was a high note to end, but today we started again. And on day two, it was all about providing the evidence. We showed you what the spending reviews are all about. We showed you some of the jobs fund work, the evaluations that come out of the jobs fund. As an example, I think we all enjoyed listening to Amanda Jitsing, where she clearly illustrated what's going on in the artisanal development environment, the constraints that used to be on the supply side for a very long time, but now the limitations, but now it's shifted. And now the limitations is now for a very long, is now sort of onto the demand side. I can't get the word out, onto the demand side here. And it was so very nice to see that. It was so clear of the problems that we've been dealing there, the institutional problems around artisan development. Donald and Iago showed us shocking figures. I know that all of us were gasping when we saw how much we're paying for seed and government. But that is the type of thing that we are seeing everywhere. When we look in these spending reviews, we notice these trends and these patterns. There's a little case study that we did on looking at stationery. And for the stationery that we have to use in our environment, the people that we have to use by the central supply database charge us a premium of between 30 to 80% above market values, above market prices. So we are basically bleeding in every small environment by paying far too much. And it's important that these studies are done. It's important that this is now is coming through for us to understand that and to find those savings in this constrained environment. We had the discussion by the Jobs Fund that showed us how successfully to bring the private sector into partnerships with government and the amazing results that they can show us on what they've achieved with these various partners. These are the type of spaces where we test the interventions and hopefully, as Andrew was trying to push, we can upscale some of these approaches if we find the right institutional format to do that. So that keeps on being a concern that we all pick up here, that we need innovative ways to think about the job creation within the path dependency, as Professor Friedman outlined to us, and the limited deregulation ability that we have, as we know, in this country. But I find the concerns around the institutional instability very important, that we need to start understanding that changing regulations, changing institutional makeup, institutional basis, changing policies like this, demanding new formats and processes in government causes a great instability. And I think some of our spending reviews also highlight that. Indeed, it was an added part of our methodology. So within the limitations of what we're facing, how do we scale up? And what is the institutional capacity that's required for that? So I think we've had a serious set of discussions here. I'm satisfied and feel intellectually, you know, enriched by this 2 days. I also would like to then say, I hope to see you again next year at this type of conference. It will be in a different platform, but it will be the same serious intellectual stimulation that we offer you here. Thank you for being here. But let me also say a few thank yous. I'd like to first of all say very much thank you to Veli and Vusi. You are definitely our superstars. Thank you for keeping the show going when the technology falls repeatedly, crumbles. You really have done well. And I think they deserve a round of applause. And if I can talk about some radio show that I would like you to think about. We've got a star that's doing his own radio show, Ubuntu Radio. I think tune in on a Friday at 12 o'clock to hear our Veli there on the radio, one of our own treasury people. I also want to say thank you to Elaine and Marie and their teams. Just thank you for your hard work, for getting it all together. Andrew, as always, for your intellectual guidance, it's invaluable. We really appreciate it. Thank you for that. I do want to thank the soldiers on the ground, the people that were running around getting the posters up, sorting out banners and sorting out so many of the small hiccups that you deal with. Thank you to you all for being here. And as I said, see you next year on a different platform.